Hello everyone. In today's session, we will see how to basically convert the inventory item into a fixed asset item. There can be cases when you treat some of the stocks as an inventory, that is current inventory, and then you would like also some of the item with a certain quantity to make it as a fixed asset. Fixed asset basically is a long-term asset for a company. Which can be of many types. So there can be an example of a car manufacturer which is basically manufacturing their cars for selling purpose, but some of the cars they want to use for their staff, and in this way they will mark those cars as fixed asset. Similarly, maybe some furniture and fixture making company which is basically manufacturing furniture, and some of the furniture they want for its internal use as a fixed asset. So there can be possibility in the system where you need to basically convert stockable items into fixed asset items. So in order to do that, first of all, we'll need to check our on-hand inventory. For that, we need to go to the inventory management module. And in inventory management module, the on-hand list page will basically show whatever items are available with on-hand quantity. So for here, I have made a note of standard cabinet, which is available in warehouse 11. So we'll just apply the current criteria. And here you can see, you know, I have applied actually already a filter. If you remove the filter, you can see all the items which are available as inventory. So in this physical inventory column minus the physical reserve quantity for certain order, the net will be available in available physical. So any of the item you would, if you would like to make it a fixed asset, you can do so. So in order to do that, I will just apply my filter on a standard cabinet for an example, which is also an stockable item here. I will apply a filter, and you can see on a warehouse number 11, basically 778 available quantity stocks are available, and basically physical inventory is showing the whole value. Then some of the items are reserved, the remaining are 778 which we can use. So we will only make one item of standard cabinet to fix asset. So we will keep this open, and we can also see the transaction of basically this item which is making this on-hand quantity through going to the transaction menu item. And you can see here there are various transactions which are basically incoming and outgoing, received or sold. The net available is shown in our on-hand form. So what we'll do is basically this last item, which is basically physical date of which is 28th of May 2022, and the item number is this one, and 100 quantity was made available with a total cost value of 2040 for these 100. If you divide by 100, so the individual cost will be 20.4 USD. So we'll make one of this item into the fixed asset. So in order to do that, we will also need to create a fixed asset code. For that, we'll use another tab here, and we'll go to the fixed assets form or page. And here we'll basically filter all the cabinet items. We'll use the contain filter. So there is one cabinet item which is basically in furniture and fixtures, and we can check whatever the books are basically assigned to it. So that already I have covered already in previous video what are the books. So you can check in my previous video. I will just create a copy of this fixed asset in order to create another code. So for that, there is a copy function available here. So I will use the copy function, and now a new code is available with all the same values. So if you want to change your value, you can do so. And if you don't want to change anything, you can use this code. So basically here, if I would like to remove the measurement, fixed asset group, I will keep it same, and location, I will remove, and the responsible person will also be removed here. And in the books also, so this is showing not acquired so far. There is no acquisition done so far. So it will show the not acquired. And if you want to change the depreciation profile, you can do so. So I will use this straight line service life here. Rather, I will use straight line service life as depreciation profile, and this is alternate and this is the main profile. So basically we need to only change this main profile here, and calculate depreciation need to be selected as yes. For this, I will rename the book name here, because we have changed the depreciation profile here. So I will make it SLSL. Similarly, I will change the name of the other book in order to basically show me the current depreciation profile. Straight line service life, tax. So now it is changed. The books are changed. So I have already noted the fixed asset code here. Okay, so the next step is basically also the date of acquisition. I will mark this as a similar date on which it was purchased basically. Okay, so that's it. Now what we need to do is go to the fixed asset module. In the fixed asset module, you can see in the journal entries, there is a journal type inventory to fixed assets journal. So I will just click this, and this will show me the area in which I can create a new journal. Okay, so here I can choose the inventory to fixed asset journal type, and the warehouse need to be the warehouse where the inventory is available, which is 11. Okay, and then after reviewing all the changes here, just click OK. It will create the journal header with the, it will also show the lines here. So you'll just click new option, and it will show you the values of warehouse which I have already selected. So I will just need to change the acquisition date, which is 28th of May 2022. This will be the acquisition date. Fixed asset number will be what we have created by copying it, or you can create a new one as you like. Okay, so this will be filing cabinet lateral. Okay, so the book value is already defaulted, which we have already changed there. And transaction type is definitely acquisition. Item number is this standard cabinet, because now it is available in our inventory module. So this is the standard cabinet. Warehouse is already defaulted. The quantity, if you would like to change, it is up to you. But since we are keeping for each of the fixed asset code a single item, so it will need to be a single item. But maybe if there is an assembly, then all of that assembly need to go into a single fixed asset code, so that the acquisition price is correct, including all its accessories. So the cost price, which we have already calculated, $20.40, is already defaulted. Now here is a single more step. If you are having a weighted average or moving average type of items, so in that case you will also need to mark the actual transaction which is coming. So in this case it is not the case, so there are no transaction available to mark. But if it is coming from a weighted average, you will need to mark exactly the same transaction, because in weighted average cost, it is a average cost of all the incoming items with the cost. So you will need to mark exact that item in order to have that accurate cost instead of the average cost. Because in fixed asset acquisition cost need to be have the specific cost instead of a weighted average cost. So you will need to mark here if it is a weighted average based item. But in our case, it is not a weighted average, so we don't need to worry about this. I will also show you the item in the release product. So here you can see this is a standard item. So this is a stockable product with a standard cost. But I was talking if it was weighted average date or moving average, these kind of valuation methods in inventory will have the average cost for each of the item. So in fixed asset, we need to have an accurate acquisition cost and a date. So we'll need to mark it if it is a weighted average cost. But for now, it is okay. If you have a location or batch number, you can add that, but here we don't need. So this is the total line here in the inventory to fixed asset journal. You just need to validate journal is okay, and you will need to post it. Right now it is showing you if you go to the books. So not yet acquired status is shown in this. So what we need to do is just post this journal. This will convert the item from inventory to the fixed asset module or subledger. So the line is posted, and now you can refresh it, and it will show you the open status here. And in order to show you the further details, so I will just open any of the report for this. Even you can go to the books here. Okay, for example, SLSL books, you can go to the transaction, and you will find here the acquisition transaction has been posted. So this is how it has been done, and you just close it, and you can also print the journal. So this is the printout available for inventory to fixed asset journal, where all the related details are shown. And then if you go to the books from the fixed asset itself, like this is a fixed asset, and you can go to the books. And if you can go to the, for example, this SLSL book and go to the transaction, where I have shown you the acquisition transaction which has passed with this amount value. The voucher is clickable. You can click the voucher in order to see the ledger transaction actually. And you will find here the single voucher is shown with the journal number. And then there is a ledger account which is raw material inventory account, basically asset account. And this, then there is a tangible fixed asset account, which is again asset account. So there is a debit from the raw credit from the raw material inventory, means the inventory is being removed for one quantity, and the same value is being debited to the asset account. So in this way, this is the ledger voucher available here, fixed asset issue, and then fixed asset debit means increase or receipt. Received of a fixed asset. And from here you can also go to the transaction origin so for the traceability, all the transactions are shown here. So for acquisition type, and then the physical and financial, the inventory transaction which has happened in inventory module, and then in the fixed asset module, the acquisition transaction are also shown for each of the book. So in this way, we have seen how we can basically convert an inventory item into a fixed asset item to show and depreciate it in a fixed asset, or make it as a disposal of that item. This will be required whenever there is a business scenario, a company which is basically manufacturing those items or trading those items, and they want to make them as an internal asset or as a fixed asset. So in that case, so that the life whenever that item is being used need to be depreciated or reduced, because something when used financially need to be reducing the value. So in this way, we will move the inventory item from inventory module to the fixed asset module, and in the similar way, because each of the sub ledger is connected to the ledger, so the ledger account need to be also credited and debited accordingly. I hope this was an informative session for you. If you have any of the comments into this, please let me know. Thank you very much, and stay tuned for more videos.